Because the Sharia, Ikhwan, brothers and sisters, came to ward off evil and harm. Ward off evil and harm. So anything that has harm in it, the Sharia ward it off. And protects the Muslims from harm. And because it's going to be a mean that would lead to that which is harmful, in that case it should be avoided for the altogether. So something simple should be given to them if they need to make a phone call or something like that. Alhamdulillah, that way they don't have access to social media and other than that. Aynam. Atfadal. Naam, Sheikh Sa'di rahimahullah. Naam, he said, الدين مبني على المصالح في جلبها والدرء للقبائح. The religion of Islam is based upon bringing about benefit and warding off evil. الدين مبني على المصالح. Those who know how to write Arabic, you can write it down. He said, الدين, الدين is the religion, الدين or the Sharia. The legislation. He said, الدين مبني على المصالح, is based upon benefit. المصالح is the plural of مصلحة. مصلحة is a benefit, welfare, benefits. So, he said, the religion of Islam is based upon bringing about benefit. Okay? الدين مبني على المصالح في جلبها. جلبها means bringing about benefit. الدين مبني على المصالح في جلبها والدرء للقبائح. And to ward off, درء means ward off. القبائح, evil things. So the Sharia, for example, commanded us to single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is from المصالح, the benefits. Not only in this world, but also in the hereafter. You reap the fruits and the benefits in this world. And also your the benefit of Tawheed, there are many. One of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give tamkeen to those people who establish at Tawheed. He will establish them upon the earth. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also he will give them security while other people are scared. They are not scared. They have security. Because Allah said in the Quran, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Those who believe and do not associate, do not mix their iman with shirk, then what is the result? Means they establish tawheed. He said, أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ. Those they will have al-amn, security. وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ, and will be guided in this world and the next world. These are the fruits of tawheed. What are the evil fruits of shirk? Many. You can't even count them. So they are evil fruits of shirk in this world and the next world. So Islam came to do what? Islam is based upon bringing about benefit. Anything that has a benefit, Islam came with that. And to ward off all evil. Aynam. That's it. نعم. Very good. There are many ways to keep the youth motivated. One of them is you read to them the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for them in Jannah. Because the reward when someone hears about paradise, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the youth in paradise, most likely they're going to be motivated. Yes. And also you mention things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned us against. Right? If we were to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, disobey his messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, being undutiful to the parents. These are the punishment. So this, inshallah ta'ala, will deter them from committing al-haram and also will encourage them to do that which is good. Likewise, also reading the biography of some of the young Sahaba. Young Sahaba. You read the biography of those companions, Ridwanullahi alayhim. This will be an incentive for them to copy the companions, Ridwanullahi alayhim, to love them and to copy them. This is also very important. Barakallahu feekum. It is praiseworthy, barakallahu feek. The question is it blameworthy or praiseworthy to prevent your child, your Salafi child, from playing with other Salafi children if they have a bad character? If they have a bad character. It is praiseworthy, barakallahu feek. It is praiseworthy because it is not from Salafiyya to have a bad character. Because the Salafi manhaj is complete and comprehensive. The Salafi manhaj has aqidah in it. Has manhaj in it. Has akhlaq in it. Because the leader, alayhi salatu wassalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about him in the Quran, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. That you are upon a great character, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And when Aisha radiallahu anha, she was asked about the mannerism of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She said, "Kana khuluquhu al-Qur'an," means that he complied with the Quran in terms of his akhlaq, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Sahaba, they were like that. The Sahaba and the Tabi'een. When you read the biography of any of the Imam, like pick up an Imam from al-A'imma al-Arba'a, for example, the four Imam. Abu Hanifa, Malik, Shafi, Ahmed, or those who came before them, you find out that they had adab, subhanallah, etiquette. They had adab. For example, Al-Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah ta'ala, and you know Al-Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah, he was an imam of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'a. He was an imam in every aspect of the Sharia. And one time, he was sick, rahimahullah, he was sick. And he was reclining. You know, when a person is sick, he reclines. You know, he sits like this, reclining, you know, because he could not sit upright. He was sick. So, there were people with him. They were discussing the affairs of hadith. And one of the narrators of hadith was not even there. His name was mentioned, Ibrahim ibn Tahman, one of the narrators of hadith. Al-Imam Ahmed, he sat upright. You know, when someone is reclining and then he sits upright, you know, you wonder why would he do that, you know? Because this man is sick. Subhanallah, he's going to sit upright. So they said, Ya Aba Abdullah, you are sick, why did you have to recline? Look what he said. He said, لا ينبغي أن يذكر الصالحون فيتكى. Subhanallah. He said, it is not befitting that the righteous people are mentioned in our presence and we recline. Subhanallah. The man was not even there. Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, when he heard his name, he sat upright. Allahu Akbar. What about when Allah is mentioned? What do you do? Subhanallah. Some people, you see them in the graveyard, wal-iyadu billah, laughing. In the graveyard, laughing. Where someone is about to be buried, or after the person is buried. Al-Hasan al-Basri, he saw a man eating in the graveyard. He said, hada munafiq. This man is a hypocrite. How can he desire food while death is in front of his eyes? So, the Salaf, they had akhlaq. Wallahi, some of them, when you read their akhlaq, you'll be shocked. For example, Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, and Nu'man ibn Thabit al-Kufi, rahmatullahi alayh. Abu Hanifa, he rented a house to someone. And the day was very hot. So Abu Hanifa, he was walking with his companion, with a friend of his. They were in the beginning of the street. In the beginning of the street. So they were walking together. Then Abu Hanifa, he changed that street. He went to the other street. Okay? Like, for example, Avenue A and Avenue B. Like next to each other. Right? They were about to walk upon Avenue A. Abu Hanifa, he changed to Avenue B. So they met at the end of the street. So the friend, he said, yeah, Imam, why did you have to change that street? He said, well, the fact of the matter, there is a house that I rented to a man in that street. And that house has like a patio, shady area, you see? And I feared that if I walked in that street, I may walk under the shade of that patio. Subhanallah. And I fear that Allah will ask me on Yawm al-Qiyamah, you rented the house to the man, why are you benefiting from it? Subhanallah. This is adab. This is adab, ikhwan. Adab, etiquette. You see, even though the man, he didn't say anything, he doesn't even know about it. But because this ulama, they have akhlaq, they have adab, subhanallah. Ibn Wahb, rahimahullah, he's a student of Imam Malik, he said, when I used to be with Imam Malik ibn Anas, his teacher, during the class, he said, I will be very careful to turn the page over so that the page does not make a crackling sound, so that I don't disturb the ear of the sheikh. Subhanallah. These are the salaf. And there are many examples. You know, I suggest we should have a seminar about akhlaq. Wallahi. Many people, they don't have good akhlaq. And that's praiseworthy, Akhil Kareem. If they don't have good akhlaq, you should not let your child play with them, even if they're Salafi. Even if they're Salafi. You choose other Salafi children who have good akhlaq, your child can play with them. Barakallahu feek. That's it, right? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all al-ilm al-nafi' wal-amal al-salih walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim.